energy requirement. So when you look at, you know, these kinds of solutions, you will find there are huge opportunities. You find that civilization, when you look at the civilization, it is nothing but a combination of three things. Comfort. We all aspire for greater comfort. The moment, you know, maybe, you know, you have a more comfortable thing, you will switch over to that. Second is, we want convenience. In terms of communications, in terms of living, in terms of, you know, say, entertainment, in terms of cooking, everywhere we want convenience. Comfort plus convenience. And the third dimension is wellness. You also want to remain healthy. Because you can't enjoy anything until next you are healthy. So comfort, convenience and wellness. So when you look at, you know, the business opportunities around that, you will have a lot of things. Now why, you know, am I talking in a seminar or in a conference where people from the technological side are there? Because we are talking about technopreneurship. Because, you know, say, the incubation center that you got here is also again an incubation center for technology. It's a technology incubation center. My, you know, maybe answer to that is that we need to bring technological intervention. And why am I saying this is, because I, you know, say, I'm, you know, say, part of many incubation centers. I'm a part of incubation center at IIM Ahmedabad. It has got a center for innovation, a center for incubation in innovation, CIIE. I, you know, say, was a part of Nirma Incubation Center. I have been a part of, you know, say, some other incubation initiatives. And I find that we need to now bring technology for better living. Application of technology, application of, you know, say, maybe, you know, say, the current, you know, the knowledge for bringing about more comfort, more convenience, more happiness, better health for the people is what is going to drive the business. You have got, for example, an iPad now. iPad is going to replace, you know, say, your, you know, obviously, you know, your laptops. Why? Because it is so very convenient. I mean, you know, on the click of, you know, the finger, you know, probably can get what you say you would be doing, you know, with the laptop. Laptop, you know, replace, you know, the table, you know, the table. So this is how, you know, we go around. You look at, you know, the mobile. Mobile has made the life, you know, very convenient. Everywhere, convenience, comfort, wellness, health, these are going to, you know, create huge opportunities, you know, for businesses. And therefore, you know, think that this is the kind of an area that, you know, that we should be looking at. Another thing, you know, say that obviously everybody is exposed to today is a global warming, environmental degradation, and therefore, green and clean. I mean, you start looking at green and clean technologies, which are going to be the futuristic thing, great, you know, opportunities for all the people that are present here. I mean, if you're thinking about that, why not, you know, say, why not think of green and clean technologies? Singapore, for example, I was, you know, sharing it with a friend of mine, you know, today's morning. The Singapore has decided that it will recycle sewage into drinking water quality, blend it, you know, say, with, you know, say, maybe the regular water supply to the tune of 5% in the year one and 25% in the year five. They want to recycle the water because that they think is the greenest of the practices. It will be green because you will be reducing the total resource use. I mean, suppose, you know, say, today Singapore is importing water from Malaysia. It will probably cut down on that import because they will be reusing their own water twice, thrice, four times. And if they are able to build this recycling, reusage, you know, say, kind of, you know, say, system, they think that they will become self-sufficient in quality water. So, green and clean, within our own country, we, you know, say, we will think that there will be huge, you know, say, opportunities over there. So, my mind, for example, you know, I think like a maverick, I think, you know, maybe out of the box. I don't think in the conventional manner. And I don't say that everybody who's present here would also be, you know, maybe, would also be the same. It is never going to be so. Because God has not created everybody equal. I'm a very bad, you know, maybe, you know, the painter. If you ask me to draw, you know, maybe this chair, I'll take probably 2 years to draw a chair. I'm pretty bad at that. Absolute dumb, you know, at that. But then some of the things come, you know, very quickly to my mind. I think, you know, maybe very differently than others when it comes to these business ideas, how, you know, it can be, you know, maybe done, how it can be designed, how, you know, it can be, you know, developed, or how, you know, this business can be scaled up. Now, those are the kinds of things which come, you know, maybe more easily to me than other things. And therefore, I say, everybody need not be an entrepreneur. All the people cannot be entrepreneurs. There have to be entrepreneurs, there have to be leaders, because an entrepreneur is a person who is creating an enterprise and then, you know, they may be actually running it in totality. Correct or not? Now that is a standard definition. You may say entrepreneur word, you know, that comes from, you know, they may be French or that, but essentially it means, you know, you are working for your own self. You are not working for somebody else. That is what an enterprising man, or that is what an entrepreneur does. And therefore, you know, we have to take into account all these factors. So whatever I'm telling you, need not apply. But one thing that I'm telling you is that today, the atmosphere that we have got, the ecosystem that we have got, is indeed far better than at any point of time in the history of the nation. I mean, go back, you know, to the 1990s, 1980s, if you want to start an enterprise of your own, you had a whole lot of problems, starting from licensing and all that. But today, that is not the situation. In the ecosystem, suppose you look at the ecosystem for starting a business, you require maybe finance, you require technological help, you want mentorship, you want markets, you want marketing help. Fortunately, there are so many instruments and so many institutions that have been created for that purpose that you are in a lot more comfortable position. The call is, of course, yours. Because, as you know, I talked to Dr. Sudhir Jain, I talked to others, as to how many people start their own enterprises. And he said, very, very few people. Because IIT, with its branding, iconic branding, it has, you know, got immense, you know, job opportunities. And I, you know, maybe just now told you what kind of, you know, the opportunities, you know, say, are there even in the field of finance. So you've got huge opportunities. So your own trade-off, I mean risk versus reward, is something, you know, which you're going to calculate. And if you find that, you know, say starting an enterprise, which could be a micro-enterprise to begin with, and they're on going into, you know, small scale, that is going to be very torturous. And if that is going to be very onerous, going to be very difficult, you know, you are definitely going to say, should I do this, or should I, you know, probably take up a job, you know, say with, you know, somebody like telco, who's going to pay me 1 lakh rupees, or I take a job in, you know, the Infosys, they pay me 1.5 lakh, or I take a foreign job which pays me 3 lakh rupees a month. Now that versus, you know, starting on your own, struggling, because please understand, starting a business, starting an enterprise of your own is indeed a very, 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 very tough job, even in the present circumstances. So, we know that maybe the benefits are there due to the fact that you have got an ecosystem. Government, you know, say, has now created MSME, and I just want to tell you, because this is very important, you must understand, that earlier we had, you know, village and khadi gramodyog industries. There was one ministry. And we had another ministry called small scale. Government of India merged the two together in the year 2006 and gave it the name MSME, that is micro, small and medium enterprise. Micro enterprise is one where, you know, your investment of 20 lakhs and lower. When you go to, you know, to small, 5 crores and lower. And when you got, you know, say to, when you go to, you know, the medium, it is around 10 crores and lower. Now that is a kind of a thing that they do. And another thing that was done by Government of India was to include services also into the definition of enterprise. So earlier to that, only manufacturing fellows were supposed to be like, you know, running industries. Now you have got manufacturing as well as services under MSME. And under MSME, there are a lot of, you know, say maybe lot of, you know, steps, lot of, you know, say kind of actions that the government has proposed. One of them is creation of incubation centers, creation of, you know, the places where you can get, you know, the finances, as, you know, maybe angel fund, as a VC. You, you know, say therefore, you know, have got to the different kinds of, you know, say tools for starting your own outfit. Now, having, you know, the, maybe, you know, the seen that in the government space, let me also tell you that in the private space, a lot of interesting things are happening. Our company was one of the first industries or one of the first companies in which a private equity people or private equity organization made an investment. I'm going back about 10, 12 years. At that time, the concept of venture capital was new to India. At that time, the concept of private equity was new to India. It was altogether new. But we were one of the first companies to be financed by, you know, say VC. And then after 3 years they exited, because when what they do is they, you know, say naturally, you know, have a band of 3, 4, 5 years. There are different kinds of, you know, say different kinds of horizons that they work with. They work with a horizon of 3 years, horizon of 5 years, horizon of 7 years, horizon of 10 years. So they've got short term and long term horizons. So within 3 years they had a mandate to exit, so they exited in 3 years. But then another maybe company came, which is called Warburg Pincus, and Warburg Pincus again invested with a mandate that they'll exit in 4 years. And they also have exited in 4 years. So we have had experience of two venture capitalist firms or so-called the private equity firms who invested in the company, made obviously a good amount of money and went out. So when I, you know, said that getting, you know, say money is not very difficult, it is, you know, from that perspective that a whole lot of, you know, say whole lot of, you know, the people with surpluses outside of India or within India have created dedicated private equity, angel funds, this fund, that fund, which is available. Only thing is that you need to go and convince them, take them on board with you as the partners. Now that is where the problem always comes up with an entrepreneur. An entrepreneur always thinks that he has got an idea and therefore he should not allow anybody else to interfere. But please understand, and this is something from my practical experience that I'm telling you, that we have been scouting around, you know, for acquisition opportunities in Europe, acquisition opportunities in America, and we have found that in 99 out of 100 cases, medium scale enterprises of the US and Europe are controlled by private equity firms. I mean, you may say that I am my own master. So far, so good. But your entire MIA is on a periodical basis, that is management information system, reports, everything in a desired format, in a designated format, goes to the private equity firms, goes to the VC firm, goes to the person who was financed. So you are owner, but you are being driven by a banker or a financier. So overall control is retained by them. So I work for a company where, let's see, there is, you know, say maybe a public limited company, there is some kind of, you know, funding available, you know, say in the equity of the company. We draw the money from there. We have to give our MIS once in 3 months. But the very same thing happens even when you are running your own enterprise. You will have, you know, say maybe very many, you know, say maybe venture capitalists or private firms sitting, you know, say on your board and driving you. They call it strategic direction. But strategic or operational, whatever it is, but they do know that maybe they do remain with you. In starting an enterprise, being an entrepreneur, you know, is not going to mean that your technological solution is enough for you to take it forward. It doesn't happen that way. You need to have a complete team. You've got technology, you should have a business development team, you should have some finance team, you should have an HR team. I mean, you've got to have the essential elements of building an enterprise. And I always want to think that when you look at any business, it has got 5 M's at its base. Manpower, money, marketing, manufacturing, and then lastly the margins. Now these 5 M's are always there. I mean, manufacturing does not mean, I mean, like, you know, traditional manufacturing, it could be manufacturing something else, like you are manufacture information, you know. So you are not maybe creating information. So that is the reason when you look at the banks come to you and they tell you that we have got 20 different products. Or you go and talk to an insurance company, they say that we have come with a wonderful product, sir, which is, you know, maybe for your children or something. We have got an insurance product which will enable you to do so and so. So when you are looking at, you know, maybe creating or your own, you know, maybe enterprise, when you know, maybe, you know, to go in any manner that you want, you must be prepared to take on board a team. You still will be the leader, but then there will be a team that will be supporting. You cannot just, you know, maybe do away with that. Second, you know, maybe thing that I have found now is that our lifestyles have changed. Entire thing has undergone a transformation. Our human relationships, they have undergone a change. So businesses, you know, say, are not created for posterities. By that I mean, you don't create a business with your child will inherit tomorrow. You don't build a business with your grandchildren will enjoy tomorrow. You are also all into, you know, say, into lines which are very different. Most of you are into lines which are very different from what your father or your other parents have done, or what your grandparents have done. And after passing out, many of you will go and say, oh, I don't want, you know, to do, you know, my father's business, which is like the auto parts. Oh, it's a, you know, it's a very bad business. Oh, I don't want, you know, to be a lawyer. I've seen my father struggling, lying, and, you know, maybe hoodwinking, you know, people. I don't want, you know, to be a lawyer. I don't want to go and stand, you know, in a black coat over there for 5 minutes, long days, and get, you know, stopped, you know, by the judge. I would like to be my own master. I would like to do so and so. I would like to do designing. I would like to do painting. I would like to do, you know, maybe, you know, say, probably, you know, say, IT engineering. I would like to do, you know, system design, whatever it is. So all of us, you know, say, are thinking differently. Today, we are all having a much higher IQ level. And obviously, we don't have to build the businesses thinking that we will, you know, continue to run it for 10, 20, 30 years. What we need to do is, we have got an idea, take that idea, convert it into something useful, take it to the next stage, take it to the fourth stage, think, you know, say, if you are making, you know, maybe a good amount of value at a certain point of time, you can, maybe, you know, exit. You can also, you know, have an exiting strategy. You can also think of, you know, building a business like a nursery, you know, does. It, you know, maybe grows the plants, and after, you know, maybe, you know, maybe, you know, some days, you know, sells. There are plants available, you know, in the US which are 10 years old, 5 years old. They're all, you know, being created in the nurseries. So you go and, you know, tell them that I have, you know, got a beautiful campus like IIT. I want, you know, to do the landscaping in the next 3 days. They'll come and do the whole thing. You'll have plants which are 10 years old, you've got plants which are 5 years old, you've got plants which are 20 years old. So the whole place is green. So businesses need not be, you know, created from the end that you will be, you know, be running it, you know, for all the time. And that is because of the present, you know, the thinking. It is not any more shameful. It is no more kind of a situation where there will be stigma attached, you know, to your selling out the business. There is no harm in that. It is as, you know, maybe simple as going for a divorce. You know, they get married. You want to get along well with each other. After some time, you say, they get a better deal. You know, if I go somewhere else. So why not, I walk out on this, ask for whatever it is, and have the value addition. More something. Yeah. Now, this is the kind of a thinking which all of you must hear. Living relationship. It has already been marriage. Correct or not? Is there anything wrong in it? Many people are happy. They are saying at least we are getting to know each other. We are seeing whether they are compatible with each other. We are seeing whether we can pull off. So four, five years, then we realize you can't get along. Say, you want to understand. Quite a few things because you have got an idea which is in sync with your likes and dislikes. I am doing all these things not because I am making more money, not because I find that this is going to give me better recognition. It is because I am very much maybe in tune with those things. I feel not like a typical businessman. I feel that we have to deliver those solutions which are socially relevant. At Syntex, that's why we work on areas which are very relevant, which are in tune with the country needs. We work on affordable housing, for example. Why? Because I feel that we must deliver great solutions for the people who are into EWS, economically weaker section, or people who are living in slums. If we can give them something which is going to be great solution, it's going to be good service to the country. Or if I look at sewage treatment, for example, and we have created a solution around sewage treatment. That it's a major problem. 90% of India, 80% of the cities do not have central sewer connection. So how do you treat the sewer? Sewer waste. How do you treat that wastewater? It has to be done in the manner that it is decentralized solution. It is done right over there. It is energy efficient. It is green, etc. So we have evolved. We have created solutions around that because this is something which is a part of my. You can say it's a part of my, maybe genetic structure. It's a part of my DNA. I said, no, we must do this. So I try to drive things towards that. For example, I am a very very fond of holistic health. So I've been working on homeopathy. I'm telling you this because I've been working on homeopathy. Again, I derive that experience from my younger days when I saw some people getting the cure through homeopathy in a very, very simple manner as against the treatment systems. So I felt that homeopathy is right, and that is very, very deeply ingrained in my mind. So for the last 10, 15 years, I've been saying I must mainstream homeopathy. But because of my various commitments, I've not yet been able to make it successful. But a few years from now, I am going to devote myself to homeopathy because I think if you want to have better health, lower cost, no side effects, nothing was better than homeopathy. And I'm supposed to be one of the champions talking about the benefits of homeopathy in various forums. They call me because they think that the kind of passion and commitment that I bring on homeopathy, the kind of scientific output, the kind of balanced output that I bring on homeopathy is not brought by anybody. So I am continuously in a flux. I'm trying to tell you is that my mind is constantly in a flux, thinking about the various things, and that's why we got an unfinished agenda. At Syntex, even after 35 years, we have got at least 10 more of the products are lined up. Each one of them has got the potential of delivering a great benefit to the society at large. And that's why when people talk to me and they say, what about CSR activities? I always say that we always, deliver solutions which are socially relevant. So we are socially responsible corporate rather than corporate social responsibility. If we are doing that, if you are giving an affordable house, 3 lakhs of rupees, medium house, which is of a top quality, which maybe benefit somebody else, I think we have done a great thing. And I remember Ratan Tata, making a statement they wrote for yesterday, and I was very delighted with that. And Ratan Tata said that I have been on the helm of affairs of Tata for maybe 30, 40 years. After retirement, I want to devote myself to delivering solutions to the masses, poor people of this country, which has been eluding them. And he talked about affordable housing. He said, we have done a nano car at 1 lakh rupees.
Why should we not think in terms of doing a house at 2-3-4 lakh rupees so that all the slum dwellers in the innocent country have got a decent living? And please understand, this is absolutely required, absolutely relevant. Country, even after so many years of independence, has not been able to provide sanitation facility to all its citizens. It is a really, really shameful thing. And I'm talking to the technologists over here, because you are all Catholic in your approach, you are all supposed to be cosmopolitan, you are all supposed to be versatile. From that angle that I'm telling you, that we must think, how can we use technology, knowledge, and all the tools to provide something, which is at an affordable cost to the masses of this country, so that the defecation in the open is completely resolved. I remember, Department of Science and Technology Secretary General used to be one, I don't remember his name, he was a Maharashtra gentleman from Mumbai. On his last day of that particular tenure that he had with the government, he was felicitated in Bombay. And he was asked, what would you like to do post-retirement? He said, I have managed the science and technology establishment for 40 long years. But now, look at Bombay tracks. Looking out of the train or the car, I find people defecating in the open. I would like to devote myself to solutions, technological solutions, appropriate solutions, affordable solutions for sanitation, for the masses of this country. This is something which I would like to do if I were now reappointed. Unfortunately, it didn't have any chance to get reappointed. But that's what he said. And that's why I am telling you that there are huge opportunities on any sphere of maybe activities that you see, there are huge opportunities. Wherever you look at, I come from Gujarat and I am from Rajasthan. Rajasthani, Marwadis, they are denounced. They are obviously, they are blamed for all kinds of things. They are also blamed a lot in northeastern part of the country and in this eastern part of the country. They are also blamed a lot. But please understand one thing. They have been creating their own enterprises. They have been running them. Sometimes in a fleecy manner, sometimes in a decent manner. But they have been running independent enterprises. It comes as a part of our genetic structure. And I am from Gujarat. And when I am in Ahmedabad, people will ask me, but aap Marwadi, yes, I'm a Marwadi. और साबरमती रिवर का पानी जिसने पी लिया वो तो जो है एक तो करेला ऊपर से नीम चढ़ा किस तरह की उसका हालत हो जाए तो बोलते हैं आप तो मारवाड़ी के ऊपर साबरमती का पानी पिया यू आर अ वेरी डेंजरस मैन opportunity in technology space, I see an opportunity in research space, I see opportunity in food space, everywhere. I must tell you that if you are willing to take the risk, please look out, please be holistic, understand that there is an ecosystem to support you. Got to be very patient, got to be persevering. It is not going to happen very easily, that's what I must tell you. Because even if you have a technological solution, it is something which needs to be taken through those levels. And after you have brought it to even a marketable level, how do you scale it up? Scalability is very important. If you want to build a big business, you need to scale it up. When you scale it up, you require actually a very different set of manufacturing processes, very different type of delivery processes. You require different logistics, you require different kind of finance, marketing, and all that. You need to do the brand building. Everything is required. How do you do it? Now this becomes very, very difficult thing. So if you are if you are having an idea, if you are having a product, please be prepared for a patient kind of working on that. At the same time, you got to be very agile because of the speed with which the changes are taking place, you've got to be agile, you've got to move, got to be very flexible, got to be very versatile. Now all these qualities you should have. If you don't have, do not feel hesitant in acquiring that. Do not feel hesitant in taking team members with you. Because doing it by yourself, everything, you will be encountering a whole lot of maybe problems which can turn your business upside down. So better maybe is that if you have got something, you will have to build all these things together and then take it forward. If you go through the book, connecting the dots, some of you might have gone through, you will find there are people who are non-graduates, people who are matriculates, people who are non-IIM, people who are non-IITs, the big enterprises. Each one of them, common thread running through all that is tremendous amount of passion and perseverance. Without passion, without perseverance, you cannot succeed in a big way. I mean, running an independent enterprise is not a very big thing. It's a very simple thing. एक शॉपकीपर भी है वो भी चलाता है अपना धंधा, एक छोटी सी फैक्ट्री वो भी चलाती है, बट यू वांट टू मेक अ डिफरेंस. यू आर ऑल फ्रॉम आईआईटी, यू आर ऑल मेक अ टेक्नोप्रेन्योर, यू वांट टू डू समथिंग व्हिच अदर्स हैव नॉट डन एंड देन यू वांट टू स्केल इट अप. नाउ दैट कॉल्स फॉर अ ग्रेट अमाउंट ऑफ पैशन, पर्सीवियरेंस. एंड एज आई ऑलवेज से दैट व्हेन वी आर डूइंग अ थिंग लाइक दिस, आई मीन मारवाड़ी एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू, फॉर मी मनी कम्स लास्ट, फॉर मी अदर थिंग्स कम फर्स्ट. एंड व्हाट आर दोस थिंग्स? You know, I want to work, you know, say, in an industrious manner. I want to work very hard. I, you know, work with initiative. I, you know, the natural, you know, I'm very naughty thinking. So, I, you know, maybe, you know, I, you know, work even intelligently. I try to make, you know, decisions. And above all, you know, I work with integrity. I was very delighted to hear, you know, Professor Barua, Director of IIT Guwahati, to say that honesty is extremely important for society. But I should also like to add to you that you can be honest. But the system is dishonest. Now, if you want to survive in this particular system, you still can maintain your honesty. But you will have to make deals. You will have to strike, you know, the kind of, you know, relationships with those people who are fundamentally dishonest. And I am the lucky of the descendants of this honesty, you know, when I was working with Asian Paints. And I went to a department called PWD, Public Works Department. Aur wahan par main gaya, humare kuch paise se phase hue the, we had to collect some payments. So, went to see, you know, the gentleman who was superintendent engineer. I went with my boss, who was the branch manager. I was the assistant branch manager. And he said, I am very honest. But the fellow who has stuck your payment, or who has dropped your payment, is dishonest. So, I was tempted to ask, as a young man, 20, 21 years of age. So, I said, what do you mean by you are honest? He said, you have paid me 2%. I've cleaned all your payments. My neighbor, my colleague, you paid him 2% and he has not released you your payment. So please take cognizance of realities of life. We are in the real world. And we have got to remember Krishna. Lord Krishna and Lord Ram, two examples of the same Vishnu. Avatar dono hai. Ramchandra ji, dead honest. First guy. Had to go and leave the tent. Came back. He came back with his wife Sita and some, you know, the dhobi and some washerman, the woman come, you know, probably, you know, whispered that Sita is not pure. Sita is not pious. When she was in Sri Lanka, probably knows whether she slept with Rama or not. There's a doubt. Ram said, prove me of his integrity. She went underground. Ram is widowed. Sent to one happiness all around. Look at Krishna. All his play flew. Krishna interprets the world in his own way. He always goes for optimum or the best solution. There are situations where you have to take a goal. You have to take a decision. Each one of them is full of dishonesty. Ashwatthama mar gaya. Now whether it is a horse Ashwatthama or it is Ashwatthama. Ashwatthama mar gaya, uska baap bhi mar gaya. This is what the Krishna is saying, oh, good. Like our Natal Vihari Vajpayee. All those were small and picky statements. Full of, loaded with the thought and meaning. So Krishna is a role model for running the world. If you want to run the world, if you run your enterprise, you have got to take cognizance of qualities of Krishna. You can take Rama as a model, but it is at your own belief. It is at your own risk. So please remember, we are in a very exciting time. You are all going to be in the country at a time when there are a lot of turbulences, a lot of problems. Don't get too much scared, because the world is the same. What I am telling you is this, and that is my last suggestion to you, is the financial architecture of this world. By that I mean the financial systems that in the world, financial, you know, the kind of edifice that the whole world has made, is full of all kinds of ambiguities and dishonesties. I don't want to get into that, but you have got, you know, an account in Mauritius, you have got an account in Switzerland. Try to ask yourself, you have an intelligent people. Is Switzerland encouraging, you know, this kind of practice or discouraging this practice? You get the answer that Switzerland itself wants people to commit important money. I had the occasion to make a presentation in Zurich 10-15 years back when India was opening up, 1992. So it was 19 years back. I was in Zurich and I was making a presentation. And one of you, one of them, maybe the bright people, got up and said, after I finished, said, you are coming from a very dishonest country. You are coming from a very corrupt country. So I said, I would like to correct you, my dear friend. Because I want to have an answer from you. Who is more corrupt, India or Switzerland? So he said, India. I said, wonderful. Great. Tell me, what is the basis of your growth and prosperity? He said, people come and deposit money. The second question that I asked him, what kind of a color does this money have? Somebody makes money out of drugs and comes and deposits. Do you deny that money deposit or do you take the deposit? He said, we take the deposit because in our country it is all honesty. So I said, you got your answer. You are terribly innocently corrupt because of the fact that you are encouraging, abetting, supporting, cooperating with the thugs of the world. If you do not give this kind of a parking place, will people be able to procure cars and bring it and park them? If you don't provide a parking place, will people bring their money and put in your banks? It is on our money that you are enjoying the kind of prosperity and happiness. You are taking our money, charging us for something that you have kept over there or pillows have kept over there. Then immediately sanitize it, put it in maybe city bank, put it in the XYZ bank, and those fellows come and then give us the money. So the challenge is very clear, and that is why I said the financial architecture of this world is such that there is very little to choose between honesty and dishonesty. I don't want you to become dishonest. Again, I said, honesty is very much a personal prerogative. It's a personal, kind of a quality. It's a personal preference. I want to be honest. I innocently be honest. I don't want to be honest. That's up to you what you want to do. But the world is full of, say, dishonest people to begin with. And therefore, we have to make a choice. We have to work with perseverance. We have to work with passion. And obviously, be prepared to walk through all kinds of ups and downs, because there is some kind of a goal, some kind of a passion, some kind of an objective that we want to achieve. And I, since it is my duty to share my experiences, I work with that passion, and that's why even at this age, at the age of 59, after having worked with 35 years of sentence, I am enthusiastic about a whole lot of new things that we as a company want to do, I as an individual want to do, and we collectively want to contribute. I think capitalism, which is naturally something which all of us are trying to pursue, is a great tool. Capitalism is a great tool. But please understand, we need to temper it with some other kind of things so that overall growth, overall prosperity, overall happiness is spread in the society. We are all maybe wonderful, bright students of the country, cream of the cream. Best of the best brains are there in IIT, and I wish that all of you think out of the box, think creatively, think differently, probe, do your own introspection and choose your path, what you want to do. You want a job, no problems, you still can be original, you can be entrepreneur in the job that you are doing, or you want to start out something on your own, with your own money, well, you can be an entrepreneur. But as I said, when you want to scale up, you will have to bring in somebody else who will be maybe again sitting on your right as a financial. Please understand, this is the reality of the world. We cannot just get away from it, because we are a part of the overall cosmos where in all kinds of forces, evil and good, are there at work. We need to find our own path and then pursue it to achieve our personal happiness, personal wellness, and as I said, comfort, convenience for the self, for the society, for the world. Thank you very much for having me.
Thank you, sir, for that amazing session. So this lecture has had a very profound effect on all our attendees. Sir, would you please come on stage? As a token of our appreciation, we'd like to extend to you a small memento. Unveiling of the management module of Technisha 2011.
बॉडी में आ जाए, एड करने के बाद में